What's up, y'all? It's your boy Mizzy Miss Cool Cat Kind of YouTube representing the Bizzers. If you like what you see, hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell, like, subscribe, and comment to the Cool Cat Kind of channel. Thank you for watching. Enjoy the video.
Not Tom Brady. I'm a kid. Daily freaking out! Baby, go. I'm a buddy, wake up. Buddy, wake up. I'm going to the playoffs, baby, because I'm a baby, wake up. Daily freaking out.
It's your boy, Missing S. Cool Cat Kind of YouTube, representing the playoff-bound Philadelphia Eagles, a.k.a. the Pirates. Yeah, I know. I know. You're going to get annoyed by the lights. I don't care. We clinched the playoff spot. It is what it is. I made a New Year's resolution, right? I made a New Year's revolution. I'm going to stop arguing with people when it comes to Jalen Hurts. Like, I'm going to stop arguing with y'all. If y'all don't love Jalen Hurts, I don't care. If you love him, love each and every one of you. I'm done arguing. So let's talk about Jalen Hurts. First things first, to all the people that says I'm nothing but a Jalen Hurts homer. Well, I criticize him too, you know. I criticize the kid too. When he has bad games, I criticize him. I do. Okay, watch the clip videos. Watch my podcast with Notion Gang, Trigger Trey Rock, and Burgain 31 on the Birds of Bar Street on Burgain Nation Sports Media. I criticize him. So, there's that. I believe in Jalen Hurts because he's a leader, he's a playmaker, he's a baller, and everyone in that locker room and that organization likes him. Now, after he beat the Washington football team with them glorious plays, on the way to the locker room, heading to the tunnel, and a rail on that dump known as FedEx Field almost hurt my dang quarterback and my fan base known as Eagles Nation. Y'all saw the clip. Y'all saw the video from Mike Garofalo. But you know what Jalen Hurts did? Like the man he is, calm, cool, and collected, picked all those fans up, took a couple of selfies with them, and went to the locker room. And then wrote a letter to Washington and the NFL telling them, I almost got killed. I almost got hurt. My fan base almost got hurt. What the heck you're going to do about it? That's a leader. That's someone I want to ride for on and off the field. And it's also funny that the Chris Sims and the Joy Taylors and the Colin Cowherd I think Shannon Sharpe. I haven't heard from Stephen A. yet, but some of the media and the national media and the local media and some of the fans are starting to believe that it's hurt season. That it's the hurt business. Business booming. They're starting to believe in the ankle breaker, the history maker, the game changer, the Saints daddy, the man of the people, Mr. Calm, Cool, Collected. Hurt season. Jalen freaking Hurts. The baby goat. The kid. That's what they like to say. He ain't the goat. He ain't Tom Brady. I mean, he is a 23-year-old piece of gold. And at the age of 23 years old, and his first full start is going to the playoffs. And his first full start, 10 rushing touchdowns. And his first year start, 3,000 passing yards. If it's now, woulda, coulda, shoulda, woulda, if wishes was fishing, we all be rich. He would have had more touchdowns, less interceptions. Because he's got 16 touchdowns, 9 interceptions. It would have been more if it hadn't been for those drops. Rigor! And also, let me say this. Russell Wilson and Deshaun Watson, they both have no trade clause. And for those of you who don't know what that means, they get to decide where they get to be traded to. Not the organization. They do. If Deshaun Watson wants to go to Miami, he will tell the Houston Texans, and they got to sign off on it and try to make it work. If Russell Wilson and Sierra wants to go to the Saints or Las Vegas, then that's where they're going to go, and they're going to make sure that the Seahawks sign on to it. Aaron Rodgers is looking like a MVP in Green Bay. I'm sure he wants to stay there or go to a contender. Gardner Minshew can stomp on down to Nick Sirianni's office, knock on his door, and say, I want a starting job as a Philadelphia Eagle. That's not how it works around here, son. And I'm sorry to disappoint everybody. There ain't a good quarterback in this draft. There really isn't. I mean, there really isn't. So you're stuck with Jalen Hurts for another season. Or more. And dang thing that any of you haters, doubters, and critics can do about it. Because if it wasn't for that 23-year-old piece of gold, you wouldn't be in the playoffs. Sure, you can say the red game. You can say the defense. You can say Nick Sirianni. You can say all of that. You can say Jalen Hurts didn't do fame. You can say he ain't good, he can't throw. He's only a runner. Mom, and he's blanking. And Jalen Hurts wouldn't even do it on the Rams. You can say all that. And you know what I'll do? I'll just ignore you. I'll just pretend you don't exist. I'll just walk away. Because again, my New Year's resolution, stop arguing with people when it comes to Jalen Hurts. Like, stop arguing. I'm not even going to argue with you. I'm done arguing with people. I know I'm side on. I side with Jalen Hurts. He's the quarterback of this. Then I ride with him. And like I said, he's so Philadelphia. Blue collar. Working 9-to-5. Don't want things handed to him. He wants to earn it. Busting that backside like Rocky, McNeil, Kevin Hart, Will Smith. say you was wrong when it comes to Jalen Hurts. Just say it. Just say it. You was wrong. You was wrong. I, insert name, was wrong when it comes to Jalen Hurts. I, insert name, will never doubt his ability again. I, insert name, will ride with the kid. Or I, insert name, will go to another team like the Dallas Cowboys, like the Buffalo Bills, like the Kansas City Chiefs, like the Patriots, like Tampa Bay, like Green Bay, like all these teams that are contenders. Go be a fan of them. I'm sure they will love you. As for me, I'm going to go celebrate the fact that we're on the playoff spot. And I'm going to ride over here in the break of hearts.